So as a junior developer, what could you typically expect to work on? Let's talk about that in today's video. This video is brought to you by the Learn Programming Academy's beginning C programming course. With 23 hours of video training contained in the course, you really can add the C programming language to your resume quickly and without fuss. Grab a massive discount and instant access by visiting lpa.dev/YouTubeC or by clicking on the link in the description of this video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about a junior developer and what you typically would work on when you're starting out. Now, obviously, a junior developer is probably going to be someone who's starting their very first programming job. So when you come into an organization as a junior developer, you're going to have other people supervising your work, and you're probably going to start on some basic things. So you'll probably spend a fair amount of time initially with documentation. You would do a lot of reading. If you've come in to learn a programming language and you don't know that, they'll probably send you off to do a course like perhaps one of mine, or a book or something like that, or even a boot camp or something to get you up to speed with a particular programming language. But if you already know a programming language and you're coming into a team, then the documentation might consist more of learning the actual code base and whatever project or projects the company is actually working on. Now, you'll start pretty basic. Most junior developers don't get in there and don't get a hands-on access to the full code base. You'll probably, depending on the size of the team, get access to part of the code base, but it'll probably typically be read-only access. In other words, you won't be able to commit any changes directly yourself. Because you can imagine that there's a huge organization, or even like a mid-sized organization, they've got a code base of code that's tested and the number of developers have worked on. If someone comes in and doesn't know what they're doing and makes a change and makes a mistake, obviously that change could be committed and updated, and it's going to break a lot of code everywhere. So consequently, there's a learning process that a junior developer, or really any developer coming into a new code base, needs to learn. But particularly as a junior developer, you'll need to learn those skills. So you'll need to learn even things like version control using Git or another repository. If you don't know those skills, you'll be sort of tasked with learning that, or being told that you'll need to learn that. So you'll go through these basic things first, learning the building blocks, and then gradually you'll get to the stage where you're asked to make some changes, and they'll generally be pretty simple ones. For example, you might be working as a junior web developer, and there might be a typo on a screen somewhere, and your change may be to find where that is in the code base and fix the typo. Really basic things, but it's done for a reason. It's getting you started to understand and learn the code base and to find out where things are, and just to gradually build your skills up over time. So that's typically the sorts of things you start off with, and then over time you'll start moving on to more and more advanced things, and perhaps you eventually get to the stage and you're working on a single method that perhaps has got a bug. Perhaps it's calculating the interest for a given amount of money and there's a bug in it under some scenarios. You'll be unit testing it perhaps, and maybe adjusting or proposing a change to it. And all the changes that you'll probably be making to any code base at this point in time will be checked by someone else. Typically a senior developer or someone else in the team will be checking your work just to make sure that you're on par. So that can be a bit intimidating, working with other people, but realize that's just really part and parcel of being a developer. Is sort of being shown the ropes and gradually proving your worth over time. So use that time really productively, and just learn as much as you can. Read a lot of the source code, read the comments, and depending on the size of the team, often there is supporting documentation and probably thousands and thousands of pages of documentation for large systems. It can be a really useful exercise to go through and look at all the design documents, to see what decisions were made for a particular code base, but then obviously reading the code itself can be extremely useful. So those are typically the types of things you work on, and then gradually you'll move up and up the ranks and be able to, you'll get commit access to the repository, meaning that you'll be sort of trusted enough to make changes without having to go through someone else. And you can understand from the company's perspective, they don't know your skills truly until you start, so things will be fairly conservative, but then gradually as you prove your worth, you move up and up the ranks, so to speak. And a funny thing that I actually saw on Reddit actually was the definition between a junior developer and a senior developer. A junior developer knows to look at Stack Overflow, great website for learning and finding answers, but a senior developer not only knows how to look, they actually know how to apply the changes as well. That's sort of the sort of thing that you'll actually learn over time. You'll find that you'll be picking up these things, you'll be researching, trying to find solutions, and Stack Overflow will come up in your Google search results all the time. It's a great site to find solutions. But as you get more and more skilled, you'll be able to start applying and understanding these Stack Overflow skills. It won't be a copy and paste, which I would never suggest you do that anyway, but you'll get to that level anyway. So stick at it and realize that you've got to start from somewhere. All programmers, with junior programmers or started a job for the first time or learned to program for the first time, you're doing the same thing as everyone else. So keep at it and I'm sure you'll succeed in the longer term. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here and I'll see you soon.